the eternal city where legend and history blend. Rome, a world influence through the ages of our civilization. For centuries, men have crossed the Tiber to Emperor Hadrian's tomb, an age-old symbol of both church and state. Another surviving structure of the imperial city is the Capitol, high on its hill. Before it stands the massive statue of Marcus Aurelius, one of the greatest Romans of them all, still looking down on the forum whence the world was once ruled. Immortal buildings, heirlooms of the past, many now being restored to resurrect the old splendor of the Caesar. The imprint of time is indelibly preserved here. Every century has left its mark. Through the beautiful Arch of Constantine, we see the Colosseum, the most imposing ruin in all the world. And there comes to mind Byron's immortal words, "While stands the Colosseum, Rome shall stand. When falls the Colosseum, Rome shall fall." Here where early Christians died gloriously, now impressive ceremonies are held. Too magnificent to perish through the ages, it has survived as a mighty symbol of the past grandeur of noble Rome. Again we see it through the arch of the Emperor Titus. Here once passed the victorious legion. In vivid contrast is the new Mussolini Forum at the Farnesina. Its present-day beauty of line is embellished with classic statues of snow-white Carrara marble. This extensive stadium forms an impressive setting for the modern Roman games. Regularly, thousands gather here to take part in athletic events arranged by the government. The new and the old in one vista, a modern monolith and the ancient dome of St. Peter's. Bulwark of Christianity through the ages, this basilica in the heart of the eternal city has for centuries inspired the devout of the world. On Palm Sunday, one of the holiest days of the Christian Church, this ancient religious shrine appears at its best. The ceremonies are deeply impressive. Rich and poor, mighty and humble, worship together. Here the Pope gives his sacred blessing to all the world. Everyone must have a bit of palm, and the Piazza San Pietro is peopled by worshippers from all lands. Another magnificent basilica is San Giovanni in Laterano, the Cathedral of Rome. Within this stately edifice, history between church and state has been made. Looking down the broad Via dell'Impero to the Palazzo Venezia, we see the monument to Victor Emmanuel, inaugurated in 1911, on the 50th anniversary of the proclamation of the Kingdom of Italy. At this modern patriotic shrine stands the tomb of Italy's unknown soldier. Here on memorial occasions, the king and his people assemble to honor their war dead and to engender peace. When Mussolini speaks, such crowds as only Europe knows surge in the square of the Piazza Venezia. Piazza del Popolo, one of the most beautiful squares of Rome. White fountains, streams of sparkling water, a broad plaza before the Church of St. Mary's of the People. the streets of Rome, picturesque Sicilian vendors and their donkey carts tempt the children with their tasty wares. It is the dream of all travelers someday to see the colossal fountain of Trevi. Massive figures about a giant basin. The legend is that those who throw in a coin will someday return. Most tourists regard this as a good gamble. The fellow who cleans the basin likely does too. The Pyramid of Colosseum. 3 miles from here, Rome's permanent exposition is being built to open in 1942. As Rome is built on seven hills, many of its beautiful buildings are seen from below. At the steps of Trinità dei Monti, the flower stands offer lovely blooms, and in nearby colorful markets, fresh fruits and vegetables are displayed with old-world artistry. Everywhere throughout the imperial city, there is the fascinating blend of the old and the new. At the Largo Argentina, recent slum clearance uncovered many precious monuments buried for centuries. Now they will rise to live again. This famous modern fountain stands in the center of the Piazza delle Cedre, at the head of Via Nazionale. Jets of sparkling water fall on bronze figures, beautiful naiads in a perpetual bath. Mighty Triton riding through the spray. Modern Rome is building rapidly. The broad avenues lined with new buildings are as impressive as those of any great world metropolis. Rome's fashionable boulevards are the center of the city social life. Here, the present-day manner of gracious living is developed to an art in a tree-lined avenue that reminds one of other noted world capitals. The hearts of most great cities are similar in appearance, and modern Rome is no exception. The traffic police are ever alert and exacting. Countless cars and buses move forward in a rapid, orderly manner. Truly a city of extreme contrast. Ancient, medieval, Renaissance, and modern. Strangely enough, all seem to blend together. When night comes on, Rome takes on the dignity appropriate to its vast magnificence. An after-dark scene ever to be remembered is the illumination of St. Peter's in honor of a saint. Cradle of history, stately citadel on the immortal Tiber. Down through the centuries, all roads have led to Rome. Today, modern highways still lead to Rome, to a modern world center, rich in tradition, yet intermingled with the inspiration of modern art and modern literature.